God's going to do something new in your hearts and your lives, because God makes all things new. God's going to do that. And I believe this year is going to be a year of hope and healing for many of you. And God's going to do something wonderful. And if you're hungry for God, God will do something. If you are not hungry for God, you're too full of yourself. Okay? So you've got to be hungry for God. Because if you're full of yourself, God can't fill you with His Holy Spirit. There's too much of you. Okay? And so Romans 12:1 speaks to us and says, we bring ourselves before God daily. And we say, use me for your glory. Here is my life, a living sacrifice. Make me dependent on you. And part of that process of being fully on fire for God is to say, renew my mind. Refresh my mind. Refresh my thinking. My old ways of thinking are mixed. Help me to walk in that new nature. And part of that thing of being hungry for God is saying, Holy Spirit, transform my living. Is that okay? As I close this morning, Luke chapter 9, verse 23, Jesus challenged his own disciples. He threw the gauntlet. What's a similar thing in Korean? Please throw the gauntlet down. Challenge. Thank you, Chris, for your support, for your help. What's it in the Philippines? You throw the gauntlet down. How does that phrase get spoken in the Philippines? That's right. Okay. See back in. Did I say that correct? What do they say in the UK? Give it a go, mate. So Jesus said to the disciples, give it a go, mate. Whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves, take up their cross daily, and what? And follow me. And then he says, whoever wants to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for me will save it. You know, to deny yourself, it's not assuming a false spirituality. To deny yourself is simply this: putting His kingdom first. That's it. To deny yourself is saying the kingdom of God comes first in my life. Who wants to do that? Three. Okay. Who wants to put the kingdom of God first in their life? Father, for every hand that is raised in this place this morning, every hand that is raised, I pray, Holy Spirit, help us. Help us with our worldview. Help us with our walk with you to put your kingdom first and not our own, not ourselves. May your kingdom shine in our heart, dear God. May we live for you. We ask this in your wonderful name. To take up the cross, put your hands down. To take up the cross daily. It's not a burden. When we take up our cross daily, we renounce our self-centered ambitions and we say, God, it's all about you. Get rid of our self-centered ambitions. Anything less than total surrender robs God of his glory, because God wants all the glory for our lives living for him. Would you stand for me? Let's pray. Father, beginning of the year, we stand here this morning as your church, and some of us are on holidays and we have some visitors here, and I pray that you bless them on their holiday break. We've got some modern students here, and we pray that you bless them, Lord God, as they start their studies and perhaps are here for the very first time. We've got families and children. But Father, we just stand here just at this moment and we ask you to realign our hearts. Father, we do it with our vehicles so we don't drive off the road, but we say, God, realign our hearts too, so we can fully be devoted to you. May our passions be on fire for you, we pray, oh God. May we thirst for more of you, Lord Jesus. Father, for some of us standing in this place this morning, you've been a believer for 20, 40, 50 years. You've been serving faithfully, and I want to say well done. But Father, I thank you that you provide a brand new year for us and new opportunities. And I thank you, dear God, that I look back in the Old Testament, some of those leaders were 60, 70, 80 years of age, still serving you, still on fire for you. So, Father, I thank you, regardless of our age, may this year, may you do amazing things, Lord God. And our response, we bow our hearts. Surrender afresh. Have your light. Thank you. love you. You're a wonderful God. We stand here today as your church. You give us so many good gifts, and we say thank you for that, God. We thank you for the gift of your Son. We thank you for the gift of the church. We thank you for the gift of family. We thank you for the gift of the person standing beside me, a friend, husband, wife, child. You're so good to us. And we pray today, do amazing things, God. We dedicate ourselves to you afresh. We consecrate ourselves afresh to you today. So, Father, I put my hands on a person beside the Lord. I pray that you bless them abundantly, God, move in their lives, Father. Bring an increase in every area in their life. I pray for health in their life today. I pray for financial blessing, breakthrough, dear God. If they need a job, a better job, Father, bring that breakthrough. Father, for friends, if they need friends, Lord God, open up that door, I pray, Lord God. So I lay my hand. I pray, Holy Spirit, do a wonderful work. Father, as we pray this week, starting tonight at 7, as we begin to pray, I ask, Holy Spirit, have your way. Move powerfully in our hearts and our lives, Lord God, as you've never done before. Put a thirst back into our spirit. Put a hunger back into our soul. And we ask this in your wonderful and your glorious name. And if you believe it, say amen. Amen. Good morning. God bless you. See you tonight.